Well, I don't do some of my homework because it has to do with drafts, but I can do like
Can you take a picture and
a
send
couple
it to
problems.
me?
Oh, I can do a couple problems though, and then I can do something else though too, so
Okay.
it's not needed.
Although, have you've never gone through that process, have you, where you took a picture and sent it to me?
Oh yeah.
Your brother's gone through it a number of times, so at
Yeah,
some
I
point
know.
you're going to want to do that. In other words, we don't
I
want
have
to
to do it
ignore
too.
all of the problems that you can't verbalize. And you're right, a lot of
Yeah, no,
problems
we've done it.
can't be verbalized. But
We've done it.
okay, so what do you got that can be verbalized here?
Well, actually, then I'm just going to email something to you
Okay.
because this is the problem I was stuck. I looked at, but I'm stuck on.
Okay. Make sure you send it to my David Cowan 1949 email address.
There, I sent it.
And did you attach it as a file or did you put it as the body of the email?
I attached it.
Good. You want to attach it as a large image if you're using an app. In other words, it gives you a choice of small or large. And okay.
So then the problem that goes with it is which one doesn't belong? Use the graph shown. Which of the ordered pairs does not belong with the other three for the graph?
Okay, I
Explain
don't
your
see
reasoning.
the ordered pairs on here.
Yeah, that's because they wouldn't fit. I can tell you them. It's 1, negative 2. Zero, negative 4. Negative 1, negative 6. And 2, negative 4.
And they're asking as to which of these pairs are not in the shaded region.
They're asking, it just asks which one doesn't belong. But the thing is, when I did it, like, they were all in the shaded region. I looked at it, and they were all in the shaded region, or close, or
Well,
on a
I see
line.
that
So
one.
I was kind of confused.
Okay.
But 1, negative 2 is...
-2 looks to be in the shaded region,
That's...
but it's questionable because that's a dotted line.
1, negative 2 is, that's because we're working with inequalities, and the inequalities that don't, that aren't... greater than or equal to are dotted.
Okay.
But the thing about 1, negative 2, it's
Look at 0,
intersect.
-4, that's in. -1, -6 is in. 2, -4 is
It's on
in
the line.
also. It's on the line. The only one that must
And
not
1, negative
belong is
2
the
is
first one
intersection.
because it's on a dotted line.
Yeah, that's what I thought. I also said that I also thought it was that because it's on the intersect.
To get the entire picture here, just back up a little bit. In other words, put your phone. Did you take this with a cell phone or a
Cell
laptop?
phone.
Okay. So back up far enough so that everything that you see in the viewer is going to be in the picture. You know what I'm saying?
Okay, I already wrote it
Can
down,
you retake
but
it and send it? Because I want to see the whole question here. Because I'm a little confused as to why 1, comma, minus 2 is not inside that region. Now I know why.
I
Now
already wrote it 1, negative 2 because I thought that it was going to be
it's because of the
because.
dotted line. If that dotted line was a solid line, then that point would be in the region. The
Yeah.
fact that it's a dotted line, well, x can certainly be 1, but minus 2 is equal to that dotted line. And it can't be equal if it's a dotted line. It's got to be less than that. So the only numbers that go in there are numbers that are entirely within the shaded region, not on the edge of it, particularly a dotted line edge. They can be on the edge of it. In other words, you also have 2 minus 4, which is on the edge of the shaded region, but it's on the solid line edge. So any point that's along this dotted line edge is not going to be inside that region. It's going to be touching it, but not inside it. And that's what they mean by which point does not belong. All right.
I just thought this other way.
Yeah. Well, the answer you gave isn't quite right.
It's the dotted line.
Because it's on the intersection. If the dotted line was a solid line, then it would be there. It would fit. And it would still be on the intersection. Okay? So it's not that it can't be on the intersection. It just can't be on an edge that's on a dotted line. That's why it doesn't belong.
Okay.
Another point that would not belong is, can you see where my cursor is pointing?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's not in that area either, because it's on the dotted line. So any point that's on this dotted line is not going to be inside the area. Whereas if I have a point that's on the solid line, like 2 comma minus 4, that's on the solid line. That is inside the area, and it's because it's a solid line.
Well, actually, the reason why there is an area is because of both lines.
Correct. In other words, the way we got this was they gave you 2 inequalities. One was a less than or... and the other was a less than or equal. And the less than produced the dotted line. The less than or equal produced the solid line.
Yeah.
But determining on as to whether a point is included in the area, it cannot be on the dotted line edge. It's not in the area if it's on the dotted line edge, including that point right there, which is on the solid line and the dotted line. Still not in the area. It's got to be completely within the area for it to be in the shaded area.
Okay, that makes sense.
Yeah. All right, what else you got?
Okay, now I have to say whether the ordered pair is the solution of the system of linear inequalities.
Okay.
So the ordered pair is 0, 0, because that's what we've been testing with. And the two inequalities are y is less than or equal to x plus 7. And y is greater than 2x plus 3.
Okay. So let's graph this, first of all. Don't have to graph it to determine whether it fits, but it's helpful. It's useful. How do I graph equation number 1, which I'll graph in black, and I will graph equation number 2 in red?
So first you're going to do is find the y-intercept, which is 7.
Okay.
And then because it's x, they mean 1x. So you go over to the right 1 and up 1.
Okay. And that's a solid or a dotted line?
That is going to be a solid.
Okay. So that's what that
area. By the way, for the other one,
and are we shading? Are we shading below or above?
We are going to be shading.
Always look to the y-axis only. Never
you're going to be
answer.
Shooting below.
Right. Never answer that question left or right. Even if it's something like this. The answer is not left or right of my line. It's above or below on the y-axis. In other words,
okay.
If it's that area, that's below. If it's this area,
uh-huh.
that's above.
Uh-huh.
But when you answer that question, is it which side of the line are we shading, it's always above or below. Never be confused by left or right. It's never left or right, regardless of what it looks like. Now, let's plot the second.
And it's, by the way, it's a greater than or equal to, not just greater than.
On the second one is greater than or equal?
Yeah.
Okay. First of all, let's shade this area.
So...
Now let's plot the second one in red.
So we're going to start up 3. And then you go 2, 1 to the right, 2 up, 1 to the right, 2 up, or 1 to the left, 2 down.
Okay, so I'll go 2 up, the 5, 1 over to the right, and that gives us that line, and in this case, the shaded area is
above.
And now what we want is
the
area that's in common, which
it's
I will
in the middle.
Surround in green. In other words, this area right here is the area defined by those two inequalities. And believe it or not, it's not an easy area to describe. In other words, if I gave you just this graph, you wouldn't be able to describe it, nor would I. The only way to describe it is with these two inequalities. Truly is.
Uh-huh.
I would not be able to describe how to draw this to you without giving you both of these inequalities. So now the question is that point inside of our green area?
No.
How can we tell, in case my graph is not quite accurate, because here's the point right here, doesn't look inside.
Well, you can tell because one of the answers is true and one of the second one is false.
Exactly.
So it's,
in other words, if this point were inside, it would have to satisfy both of these. And it satisfies mm-hmm. the first one. 0 is definitely less than 7, but 0 is not greater than 3, which is what you get if mm-hmm. you plug it into the second one. So since that one's wrong, that point is wrong. Whatever point, you wouldn't really have to graph it. In other words, I graphed it just so we could see a graph and talk about graphing, because graphing is an integral part of studying this. But in terms of telling whether a point is inside the area or not, it merely has to satisfy both. If it satisfies both, then it's, mm-hmm. it satisfies. It's in the area. Now, let me change this slightly. Here, I'm going to do something. I'm going to change that so that it's just greater than. Now I'm going to give you a point and ask you whether it's in the area or not. Point is 0, 3. Is that in the area that is created by those two inequalities?
No.
Because it doesn't satisfy the second one. 3 is not greater than 3. If I left that in, now does it?
If I left what?
If I would have left the greater than or equal to in instead of erasing the horizontal part of it?
No.
Now does it? Is 0, 3 in these two inequalities? Answer is yes.
No. Mm-hmm.
Because for the second one, I would get 3 is greater than or equal to 4 plus 3. That's a true statement.
Yeah.
As long as it's greater than or equal, it's a true statement. If it was just greater than it's not a true statement. But so this point is in those two inequalities, common area. But that's all you have to do on any of these. You don't have to graph them. You don't have to figure out if it's in the graph area. You just have to substitute and make sure that all of them are true for each of the points that they give you.
Yeah.
You have another one like that?
Yeah. The points are 4, negative 3.
What's the point?
What? 4, negative 3.
Okay. And what's the 2?
And the equation, y is less than or equal to negative 1 plus 1.
Negative x plus 1?
Negative 1. Negative x plus 1. Sorry. And the second one is y is less than or equal to 5x minus 2.
So let's see if both of these are true with these two points. How about the first one?
First one's true.
Well, prove it to me. Tell me what to write.
Because 3.
Negative 3.
Negative 3 is less than or equal to negative 3.
Negative 4 plus 1. Let's do it that way. And that is a true statement. That's a true statement.
Yeah.
And now on the second one, we'd have what? Negative 3 is less than or equal to?
Is less than or equal to negative
4 minus 2. So that's negative 3 is less than or equal to 18. That's also a true statement. As long as both statements are true, that point is in that area.
Uh-huh. So they are.
Yes. And that's a real easy way of doing these kind of problems. Not even worrying about the graph. Although, the first problem you gave me was interesting in that it had a dot. The first problem you gave me would have actually been easier to solve had I had the two inequalities. Because then I could have just plugged in that point and it would not have satisfied one of them.
Uh-huh.
A little harder to tell from the picture. Remember the picture? We had to figure out whether we were on the dotted line or the solid line, and it wasn't clear what was inside the shaded area. Well, this, when you do it algebraically, it's totally clear. It has to absolutely satisfy both. These aren't equations, they're inequalities. It has to satisfy all the inequalities that are at play. And you can have multiple ones. In other words, when you get into algebra 2, you can have a line like that, you can have another line like that, and you can have a third line like that. And then this is the shaded area, okay?
Uh-huh.
And that would be defined by three different lines. This one, and that one. Now, when I said never go left and right, there's one exception. If I say x is greater than 5, well, that's a vertical line, right?
Uh-huh.
Which side of that do I shade?
You are going to be shading the left. No, I mean the right, sorry.
Right, because x goes positive in that direction. So it would be that side.
Yeah.
So the only time you're going to use the word left and right is if X is what's greater than or less than. If it's Y, then you always are looking to the Y-axis, and it's always either above or below. In other words, even if I had a line like this, and my shaded area was this side there, I'm not going to say right. It's not to the right of my line. It's above my line. Because I'm looking to the y-axis. I'm just finding a point on the y-axis that's greater than my line. There's a point that tells me which side to shade. Okay, what else you got? You got 6 minutes.
This isn't the same thing, but it stumped me. It's finding if as with the system has one solution, no solution, or infinitely many solutions.
Okay.
It's 2x minus 2y equals 18, and then x minus y equals 4.
I got it right?
Yeah.
Okay. How are we going to solve this? To see whether or not this has a solution or no solutions.
For the first one, we're going to have to subtract x on both sides.
Let's solve this by elimination.
Okay.
Remember how to solve by elimination?
Yeah. So it's going to be...
What do we need to do to the bottom equation?
We're going to have to multiply it by negative 2.
Okay, so that means negative 2 there plus 2 there, and that becomes minus 8, correct?
Uh-huh.
Now, try to eliminate a variable. What happens?
No solution.
Right, because you get 0 equals 10. Yeah. Whenever you get one number equals a different number, that always means no solution.
Yeah.
Now let's talk about something for a moment. Is this possible?
No.
No. In other words, you can't have x plus y equal 10 at the same time x plus y equals a different number. Because if I tried to solve this by elimination, and you can subtract equations also. So I'm going to subtract equation 2 from equation 1, and I'm going to get 0 on that side equals 1. No solution. I got one number equal another number. Now, let's not go anywhere yet. I want to cover all three situations here. How about this problem? In other words, x plus y equal 10 is equation 1. 2x plus 2y equals 20 is equation 2.
Well, yeah, both if x and y were both fine. That'd be true.
There are an infinite number of solutions here. And the way I know is if I multiply the top by 2 and subtract, I get 0 equals 0. In other words, I cannot solve for x or y. I can certainly come up with one solution. You came up with one. 5 and 5 is a solution, but so is 6 and 4. In other words, x could be 6, y could be 4. Also, x could be 7, y could be 3. And in fact, x could be minus 1, y could be 11. So there are an infinite number of solutions. But what I want you to notice here is that equation 2 is the same as equation 1. It's not a different equation. You have to have two different equations to be able to solve something by elimination or to solve a system of two equations. You can't just take one equation, multiply it by 2, and have a different equation. And equation 2, you'll notice, is equation 1 multiplied by 2. Right? Mm-hmm. Therefore, it's not a separate equation. In other words, that's no different than equation 1. So what I really have is one equation and two unknowns. And whenever you have this, it's always an infinite number of solutions. When you have more variables than you have equations, you cannot solve it, ever.
Uh-huh.
And adding a second equation, in other words, if I wanted to add this equation, 3x plus 3y equals 30, I haven't added any information. I've come up with a second equation, but it's not a different equation. It's the same equation, merely a multiple of it. So whenever you have two equations and one equation is just a multiple of the other, you know you have an infinite number of solutions. So here's the way you can tell. When you get a number equals another number, that's no solution. When you get 0 equals 0, that's an infinite number of solutions. And if you're able to solve for one of the variables, that's the real solution. In other words, let me change the problem slightly. I'm going to have to run here in 2 seconds. Make it x minus y equals 10. Well, now I can solve that. Notice that that does not give me any problems. If I add these two equations, I get 2x equals 20. X equals 10. If x equals 10, y has to be 0. Both of those are correct for both of these two equations. So always remember that when you're looking at a system of simultaneous equations, make sure they're different. That's different.
Okay.
But if I just took the first one and multiplied both sides by 2, I do not have a different equation.
Uh-huh.
All right. Logan, I will let you go, and I will talk to you next week.
Okay.
All right, bye-bye.